Welcome to another video on the chain rule. This video focuses on finding the derivatives of transcendental functions. You may want to watch the previous videos on the chain rule. They do explain the concept of the chain rule in much more detail. But to review, the chain rule provides a technique for finding the derivative of a composite function. It can be written using Leibniz notation or function notation, but essentially what it states is the derivative of a composite function is equal to the derivative of the outer function times the derivative of the inner function, where u would be the inner function. And that's very important because when we look at a composite function, we will always let u equal the inner function. So if we take a look at all the derivative formulas that we've discussed so far, notice now all of the x's have been replaced with u's, meaning that u could be an inner function. Now if you look at the derivatives of all of these, you'll find a product where the first expression would be the derivative of the outer function, and u prime would be the derivative of the inner function. So identifying u is the key component to applying the chain rule properly. Let's go ahead and take a look at some examples. We want to find the derivative of each function. G of x is equal to negative 2 cosine 4x. So we have an outer function of cosine, and we have an inner function of 4x. So what that means is that our u will equal 4x. If you look at this derivative formula, you can see that our u would be 4x. Let's go ahead and record this. As soon as we know we have a u, we need to find u prime. Well, u prime is the derivative of 4x, which is equal to 4. Now if we look at this, if this is our u, we should view this as negative 2 cosine u. So now we can find the derivative of g of x. G prime of x is equal to negative 2 times the derivative of cosine u, which is negative sine u, times u prime. But of course, our derivative needs to be in terms of x, not u. So now we replace u with 4x and u prime with 4. So our final derivative will be positive 8 sine 4x. Let's go ahead and take a look at another one. The first thing we should recognize on this problem is that we cannot find the derivative in this form. Let's go ahead and rewrite this using rational exponents. And let's rewrite this as sine x raised to the third power. So we'd have x to the 1/3 plus 1/2 times sine x raised to the third power. Now this is not a composite function, but 1/2 sine x to the third is a composite function. Our inner function would be sine x. So if u is equal to sine x, we know we're going to have to find u prime, and u prime would be cosine x. So now when we look at this, we should see the term 1/2 u to the third. Okay, let's go ahead and find our derivative now. F prime of x is equal to the derivative of x to the 1/3 power would be 1/3 x to the 1/3 minus 1, that would be negative 2/3, plus the derivative of 1/2 u cubed, that would be 1/2 times, well, the derivative of u cubed would be 3u squared times u prime. But of course, we can't leave it in terms of u. Let's go ahead and replace u with sine x and u prime with cosine x. Let's also clean this up. This would be 1 over 3 x to the 2/3 power in the denominator, plus this would be 3/2. U squared is sine x squared, and u prime is cosine x. Now we could rewrite it so this exponent of 2 is in this position, but I'm going to go ahead and leave it like that. Now a lot of times what we'll do is perform what's called mental u substitution, where we'll kind of leave out this step and go straight to this step down here. But when you're first learning the chain rule, I think it is helpful to leave it in terms of u temporarily and then do the substitution in the last step. Let's take a look at a couple more examples. Again, we know from previous examples that we don't find derivatives when things are in radical forms. Let's go ahead and rewrite this using rational exponents. So both of these are composite functions. In this first term, we should think of u as being x to the 1/2 power. Well, Well, I'll call this u sub 1. And on the second term, u sub 2 is going to equal sine x. So this would be u to the 1/2. And this would be sine u. Next thing, we know we're going to have to find the derivatives of these u's. Let's go ahead and do that. U1 prime is equal to 1/2 x to the negative 1/2. And u sub 2 prime, the derivative of sine x is cosine x. Okay, so now looking at this in terms of u, we should see this as y equals sine u plus u to the 1/2. And this is our u sub 1, this is our u sub 2. Let's go ahead and find the derivative now. So derivative of sine u is equal to cosine u times u prime. So we'll have cosine of u, which is really x to the 1/2, times u prime, which is here, which could be written as 1 over 2x to the 1/2. Let's go ahead and put that in parentheses. Plus, now we need to find the derivative of u to the 1/2, and that would be equal to 1/2 u to the 1/2 minus 1, that'd be negative 1/2. Well, our u is actually sine x times u prime, and our u prime is cosine x. Okay, so this derivative was much more challenging. Let's go ahead and see if we can clean this up a little bit, and then we'll call it good. X to the 1/2 is really the same thing as the square root of x. We'll have the cosine square root of x all over 2, and this is also square root of x, plus over here we'd have a cosine x in the numerator, and our denominator would be 2, and this would be the square root of sine x. Sometimes it's a little more difficult to follow when we have two different terms that both require the chain rule, but using subscripts can help us keep those straight. Let's go ahead and take a look at one more. Okay, on this last example, I want to take a look at the logs first. The power property of logs says we can take this exponent here and move it to the front, so it's 2 times natural log x. Now, we can't do that here because this power is attached to the entire log, and here it's only attached to the x. Let's go ahead and rewrite this as y equals e to the power of 4x plus 2 natural log x minus natural log x all raised to the second power. Now this term is no longer a composite. Only the first and third term are composites. So on this first term, our u would equal 4x. So our u prime would be equal to 4. Second term is not a composite. And this last term, the inner function, is u equals natural log x. So therefore, u prime is equal to 1 over x. And again, if it helps, I'll call these u sub 1s and these u sub 2s. Okay, let's see if we can find the derivatives now. So when we look at this now, we should see e to the u. The derivative of e to the u is equal to e to the u times u prime. So e to the u would be e to the 4x times u prime, well, u prime is 4, plus the derivative of 2 natural log x, that'd be just 2 times 1 over x, minus, now again, this inner function is our u, so this is really u squared. The derivative of u squared would be 2 times u to the first, which is natural log x, times u prime, which is 1 over x. Let's clean this up and see what we have. Here we have 4 e to the power of 4x plus 2 over x. Here it looks like we'd have minus 2 natural log x divided by x. And we'll go ahead and leave it like that. Okay, so as you can see, when we apply the chain rule, it can get a lot more involved than what we're used to. I hope you found these examples helpful. I will have one more video that talks about the chain rule combined with the product and quotient rule with transcendental functions. Thank you for watching.